The black magicians have their mysticism, and they always firmly believe that they walk on the good path. No black magician believes that he walks on the evil path. The path of black magic is a broad way filled with vices and pleasures, but the ultimate end is total loss.
Worship enters into it, but as something that you choose to do to get the benefit of it. The Easterners have a term for it called bhakti yoga. This means the yoga of worship, but yoga is a system. So if we worship a deity, a goddess, or a god or something like that, we're doing it for a purpose. The Legaton and the Greater Key of Solomon, these handbooks of magic were attributed to Solomon for two reasons. Number one, he was the great magician, the legendary magician, and number two, these people were afraid to put their own names on the books because they'd get burned at the stake. Solomon is, of course, originally the king of Israel in the Book of Kings in the Bible. And he lived around 800 BC, and he was the great king who built Solomon's temple. So now from his legend, if you will, arises the Masonic fraternity, and also arises the legend of Solomon the Great Magician. He supposedly mastered the demons and the spirits and as the Arabians say, the jinn. I didn't bother to do a closing pentagram or to close the circle or to banish the spirit or anything like that. Somebody just left. And then 3 hours later, she grabbed me out of a sound sleep and sunk her fingernails into me and woke me up, and she was staring up at the ceiling, and she said, "There he is." And I had to drag her back into the circle, and we had to exorcise that spirit.
Magical rituals weren't only prominent in Babylon, or later in the kingdom of Judah. It was also very much part of ancient Egypt, and was also part of their religious practices. Ancient Egyptian religion was a complex system of beliefs and rituals which was integral to ancient Egyptian society. It centered on the Egyptians' interaction with a multitude of deities who were believed to be present in and in control of the forces and elements of nature. The myths about these gods were meant to explain the origins and behavior of the forces they represented, and the practices of Egyptian religion were efforts to provide for the gods and gain their favor. Formal religious practice centered on the pharaoh, the king of Egypt. Although he was a human, the pharaoh was believed to possess a divine power, and was considered a god by virtue of his kingship.
إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم إنه كان من المفسدين ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين.
He acted as the intermediary between his people and the gods, and was obligated to sustain the gods through rituals and offerings so that they could maintain order in the universe. Therefore, the state dedicated enormous resources to the performance of these rituals and to the construction of the temples where they were carried out. Individuals could also interact with the gods for their own purposes, appealing for their help through prayer or compelling them to act through magic.